Fiji has become part of the sports branding culture, sports apparel. Coaches, team players wearing these things. Made popular by the Sevens rugby sledge organizations to discuss it in particular, the partnership or the gifts such as balance, respect, compassion, and love in sport. These discussions include cultivating virtues of faith.
Vice Chancellor, University of the South Pacific, permanent secretaries, participants, ladies and gentlemen, greetings and ulabinaka to you all. I join with the Vice Chancellor this morning in welcoming all our brothers and sisters from Pacific here in Suva. Indeed, I'm delighted to be invited to this regional forum for sports in the Pacific. Equally pleasing is the fact that this forum coincides with the Oceania Rugby Sevens Championship, which is happening this week here in Suva. That is also part of the 2020 Olympic qualifiers. Ladies and gentlemen, sports have long been regarded as an important enabler in nation building. For Pacific Island countries, it has proven to be a unifier as well and brings our different communities together in an inclusive way. A fine example is the Oceania Rugby Sevens Championship, which is an important pathway for many of our sports people towards the international sporting. And for this, the Fijian government recognizes the value and social and economic benefit it brings to our nation. The Reserve Bank of Fiji in 2016 placed earning from sports, including remittance and sports tourism, as 1.7% of Fiji's GDP, placing it above industries like forestry and logging, fishing and mining. These figures justify the Fiji government funding of the tournament for 3 years to enable our rugby playing family in Oceania to meet and participate in an international tournament. To walk the talk about inclusive sports, this year, for the first time, we will have a competition for the hearing. Ladies and gentlemen, the 3 days earmarked for this important forum will not only benefit our cause to promote sports for wellness, competition, and as I have pointed out, towards economic growth, but to also provide pathways towards improving standards and increasing the number of professional athletes from the region. On behalf of the Fijian government, I extend our appreciation to UNESCO and USP for their support, which has allowed us, the regional stakeholders, to convene Suva this week and consult with the Pacific Sports Physical Activity and Physical Education Action Plan 2019-2013. This document, I believe and I know, is the direct outcome of the various meetings of key stakeholders from respective countries. The most recent one held in Samoa in July 2019. Among resolutions so far, I believe our goals to recognize the strong capacity of small island developing states in sport and the use of sport as a vehicle to foster development, social strengthen education, promote health, and build life skills. It is encouraging to note that the action plan has included 5 priority action areas, including advocacy and communication, regional consultation, coordination and action, policy development and consultation, monitoring and evaluation, and lastly, research and education. Therefore, I am confident that this forum has taken on board the suggestions to include stakeholders to develop and deliver the action plan in a visionary and an inclusive manner. Each one of us, as Pacific Island countries, operate at a different level and are at different levels of development as far as support is concerned. What works for us here in Fiji may not be the right fit for you. However, this forum is all about generating ideas and discussions. It is, in some ways, a sandpit to throw ideas around. And I hope that this forum is able to structure those sandpit ideas into terms of strengthening the sports sector in the Pacific. Ladies and gentlemen, capacity building is one of the key areas in the development of a policy. This was identified as one of the important policy to focus on through a series of consultation with regional bodies for sports and civil society organizations initiated by the Oceania National Olympic Committee, Sport Matters and UNESCO in 2018. On that note, I extend the appreciation of the Fijian government to our Samoan counterpart for successfully hosting the 2019 Pacific Island Sports Ministers Meeting that has become part of this process. We can all agree on the valuable contribution of sports in the social, cultural and economic life of the people of the Pacific. But let us all continue to strongly advocate for the continuation of investment in our greatest resource, which is our people. We have seen raw talent in abundance shaped into competitive international teams at the recent Rugby World Cup among Pacific nations. However, our lack of success beyond a certain point is due to the lack of infrastructure and the investment needed to complete at the international level from earlier age groups into our national teams. And this is evident when our teams fail to have that X factor of money and facilities that cuts off tier one countries from the rest in world sports. Let us continue to highlight the importance of standing international and regional frameworks such as 2030 Agenda and Sustainable Development Goals, Samoa Partnerships, Framework for Pacific Region, the Pacific Roadmap for Sustainable Development, the Kaizen Action Plan, and the Action Plan 2019-2030, which highlights the importance of sports as a vehicle to drive development, promote peace, and foster empowerment and inclusive participation. The Fijian government acknowledged the support that this important forum and during the next 3 days look forward to an interactive policy dialogue on key policies areas including physical activity and health, physical education, high performance, integrity, climate action, human rights, gender, disability and youth. Ladies and gentlemen, this forum also gives us an opportunity address the ongoing manipulation in sports at national, regional and global competitions, which undermine the value of sports. Our deliberations must also ensure that countries are able to exchange with each other and have concrete guidance on next steps, developing the national action plan and opportunities to establish national platform for sports integrity in the fight against manipulation of sports competition. Currently, the Fijian government is working towards a new national sports and recreational activities policy and incorporating several new policies to protect Fijian athletes and sports, a drug-free sports act, safety in sports policy, child protection policy, and sports governance code. We have taken a step forward in the national anti-doping policy, which, if passed, will be the first in the Pacific region. Our plan does not rest only on the policy itself, but as a side on having a national anti-doping bill, which will assist in the establishment of Fiji's own national anti-doping organization. We are very keen for our national sporting organizations to create their own sports development plans to create pathways for the youth and sports growth, which will benefit our young people who make up 70% of our national population. Ladies and gentlemen, Fiji stands ready to support, lead, and collaborate widely on the Pacific Action Plan to discuss ways to leverage sports investment as a contributor to the Sustainable Development Goals, sports and human rights, as well as enhancing common world cooperation on a sports policy agenda. I am hopeful, looking into the future, we can strengthen collaboration with one another and render assistance in the Pacific way to our Pacific counterparts. I wish you well in your deliberation. Thank you.
And thank you very much, the Permanent Secretary for the Ministry of Forests, for your